Welcome, everybody, to the Martin E. Siegel Theater Center here at the Graduate Center CUNY. And thank you for taking time out of your for sure busy life to be with us tonight. I think you will be very happy to have come. It's something very rare and very, very difficult, actually, to see what we present tonight in our international theater series is Kagura, Shinto Temple Dance, from early Japan with Miho Takeyasu. And my name is Frank Henschko. I'm the executive director and director of programs here at the Siegel Center. And we bridge academia and professional theater, international and American theater. And we are one of many centers here at the Graduate Center CUNY that does public programs like this. We would like to thank Andrzej Wirt, who's also going to talk a bit about Kagura Dance, who made the suggestion to us, helped us to bring Miho Takeyasu over here. So thank you, Andrzej, for being such a good friend of our center. The format of the evening will be a very short introduction, the dance piece, then the dancer, Miho, will talk a bit about her work. Then we have a little discussion with her and the panel here, and then we will open up to questions from the audience. And this will be followed by a reception here in the room. Will not be longer than 90 minutes, most probably a bit shorter. And again, thank you all for coming, and I hope you will also stay for the reception. If you have a cell phone, just take it out for one moment and see if it's, I'll do the same. See if it's power off, especially for the panelists, leave all the phones behind. We can't have them up here. And again, thank you. And now, I would like to ask Professor Andrzej Wirt, a professor of theater, a great international theater scholar who carries a lot of world history of theater with him, to say a few words about Kagura and why he thought we have to show this at the Siegel Center.
Yes, thank you. Thank you. Good evening. I am Andrzej Wirt, but I'm now, if I'm now at all, to people in Europe, and now here under anagram ATW, and this is anagram of the school I founded in Germany. And by the way, last week, 30 years of the School of Gießen was celebrated in the same house. This, of course, does not sound good, sounds uncertain, incestuous relationship, and this is an incest, but what is actually worse, what is bad with incest? Without incest, we would not have Greek tragedy. after saying it, I have to say that actually I don't want to say anything too informative, because I want you to experience what I experienced in Berlin a year ago, when Miho Takeyasu, as a surprise for my round birthday, danced in Hebel Theater, which is a prominent avant-garde theater in Berlin, Kagura. And this Kagura was devoted to me. And this was a peculiar experience in which exoticism of the East corresponded with something which we know from the Christian culture, a mass for the benefit of the sick or dying. So at the moment we decided to surprise you. And I hope that giving, without further explanation, performance of Miho Takeyasu, you will experience what I experienced a year ago in Hebel Theater. Thank you.
evening. I am Miho Takayasu. First of all, I would like to thank Program Director Dr. Frank Henschke, who gave me this great opportunity to hold an event at the Martin E. Segal Theater Center of New York City University. And I am really glad that you came to this event and I could meet you. Today, I will talk about Kagura, Shinto temple dance from early Japan. And I am going to perform Kagura in front of you. The word Kagura itself, writing with the Chinese characters for God and music, or to make the gods happy. As a good luck dance, it is dance of Shinto deities, and it's seen only by the god, Kami. You see me from the back dancing two dances before the deity. The first dance is called Wishing Frank's family good luck. The second dance is called Protect Frank's family against misfortune. Normally, a Shinto priest presents the wish to a diving addressee. Today, however, I will be writing down and reading aloud Frank and Frank's family's wish, following my concept of Kagura. Then I shall call up the god of my dance with my bells. And hand him Frank's request.
Thank you. I will talk about... I will talk about Kagura. There are any varieties of Kagura, depending on the region in Japan. The performed, the Kagura I perform is an original Kagura performed in Osaka, Kansai region. I want to introduce you to the so-called Naniwa Kagura in Osaka. Naniwa Kagura is one such example of Miko Kagura. Miko Kagura is the oldest type of Kagura. So, let us see a 3-minute introduction video about the Naniwa Kagura.
Thank you so much, Charlie.
Thank you.
Thank you. Again, thank you all for coming, and thank you for that truly mysterious and beautiful performance. What you all saw is one of the oldest forms of dance known to mankind. It goes back to the 13th century, hasn't been changed. If I understand right, it was the words of the goddess delivered to the people.
そうですね。はい、that's right.
And are you the first and the only one of a former temple dancer who's also working as a professional actress? Is that normal that you do both?
そうですね。ミコさんをやりながら現代役者を俳優をやっているのはあなた一人ですか？
はい、そうです。巫女さんであるという人は何人かいらっしゃいますが、その中で、現代俳優、パフォーマーとして活動しているのは私だけです。
Yes, that's right. There are several Mikos still performing today, but I am the only one who also performs as a contemporary performer, stage actress.
You're actually in a company that is named after German writer Heiner Müller. Is that true?
Heiner Müller. Heiner Müller's Hamlet Machine を上演するところから劇団ができました。ですから、HMP シアターカンパニーと言いますが、Hamlet Machine Project.
So the theater company that I'm a part of, our first production was Hamlet Machine by Heiner Müller. So our company is called HMP, Hamlet Machine Productions Theater Company.
Well, as you say, leave it to Japan to combine, you know, truly ancient forms and contemporary art. And what seems to be unthinkable for so many others, Japan is able to do this. We don't really know how Shakespeare really was performed, how was...Goethe performed in Germany or Racine, but you will, you, what you saw here was performed 700 or 800 years ago in the same movements, in the same dance steps, and that is quite sensational, I do think. So if I understand right, this is normally performed in the temple.
Hi, so this.
Are you the only one who performs it outside the temple?
I
am not the only one who performs the dance rituals outside of the temple.
例えば日本にはたくさんの神楽があります。先ほども紹介しましたが、ニューヨークやヨーロッパでも他の神楽のジャンルは上演されていると思いされています。ただ私の
ちょっとそこなんです。すみません。はい。As I was explaining earlier in the presentation, there are several different kinds of kagura in Japan according to the different regions, and there are some of those other forms of kagura that have toured.To the U.S. or Europe.
で、私の生まれ育った町は、大阪府の八尾市というところで人口が27万人ほどいます。で、私の子供の頃の記憶ですが、巫女は5人から10人ほどでした。で、その地域の神社をすべて回っていました。その
In the town where I was born and grew up, it's a population of about 270,000 people, a city called Yaoshi. I remember that there were about between 5 to 10 mikos who would perform all of the dances in the temples of the region.
その中で今こうやって舞台に出ているのは私だけだと。
はい。And so among that school of Kagura, I am the only one who has taken it outside of the temple.
Mm-hmm. And is it normally performed by girls or young girls? And or do I understand that right?
普通はあの女性あの特に若い女の子が舞うものなんです。
はい。この神楽に関しては、20歳までと私の地域では決まっていました。
For this particular form of Kagura, it was, you could perform, girls performed it up until the age of 20.
もちろん地域によっては違うと思います。
Of course, that depended on the region of that Kagura came from.
Mm-hmm. So you would, compared to Indian dance, where every, you know, hand movement has a very clear connotation, it's almost like a spoken language. The movement of the fan or dance movement, is there a syntax, is there a language behind?
例えばインドの伝統の踊りだと、一つ一つの手の動きなどに意味があるんですが、これも同じですか？あのセンスの使い方とか、あの手の回し方とかに意味が一つ一つあるのでしょうか？
そうですね。基本的には3つ意味があると思います。払う、清める、拝むという動作、この儀式の動作がこの手の動きに現れていますね。
Fundamentally, I would say that there are three kinds of meaning to the gestures of the dance because the dance is really coming from the rituals.So the three meanings would be to expel evil spirits, to
払う清める
to purify the spirit,
拝む
and to worship the deities.
Mm-hmm. So my question, for example, when you had these kind of razor blade movements which you repeated, is there a specific meaning or these movements as holy movements itself?
だから一つ例えばこのセンスの使い方でこうやって回す動きがあったんですが、それの動き自体に意味はあるんですか？
ここの回していたのは、胡蝶あずま舞という舞を私がアレンジしていますが、蝶々の動きをイメージしています。
So that is a part of the dance that あなたが作ったんですか？
胡蝶あずま舞という舞があります。今日は4つの舞を合わせているんですね。その最後のところが胡蝶あずま舞です。
So what you saw today was actually a combination of four different dances that I arranged myself. And the last part of it, where you saw the twirling fans, is called 胡蝶
あずま舞。
And the image for that part is butterflies.The twirling fans representing butterflies.
Representing butterflies, wonderful. I was the lucky recipient of your, you know, of your spiritual love tonight. So, is it? So people come and ask for the dance, or whoever invites you is honored with the dance. How does that work?
それどういう仕組みなんですか？一般人が頼んでその人のために舞うんですか？どういう仕組みで？
そうです。神楽殿に、神楽殿って言ってもいいのか、神社に皆さんがお越しになって、神様に願いを届けるために舞を奉納するんですね。
奉納というのは、
奉納、納める。神様に納めるために、皆様が来られます。ですから、フランクさんのために、もしくはあなたのためにというのを一人ずつ、そのご家族のために待っております。
So the general population can come to a shrine and ask for the dance.Particularly for that person or for their family members, and that is a ritual that ensures their wishes is heard by the gods.
And I think he said it's often given to someone who is sick or who is in a hospital or for birthdays. So it's for what are occasions? What do people ask for?
あの踊りをあの舞を頼みに行くんですが、あの病院とか、mm-hmm. あの誰かの誕生日とかそういうどういう時に、
すべての時だと思いますが、お祭りの際に皆さんが家内安全ですとか健康ですとかそれぞれの願いを届けに来られます。でも私はその願いを何を願っておられるかは知りません。
So there are, I dance for any and all occasions. Frequently during festival times, people will come and, for example, pray for the safety of their home, health and happiness. But I, as the one who's performing the ritual dance, don't know specifically what the wish is.
Oh, so it's a secret.
そうですね。
That's right.
Mm-hmm. And so this is traditionally or exclusively performed by women. Men do not
dance. 男性は舞わない。舞うことはないですか？
なにわかぐらに関してはありません。
In なにわかぐら, which is my form of dance, no, there are no men.
みこかぐらもありません。
In みこかぐら, also there are no men.
So the idea of the priestess.Your interpretation of a female is the god, your god, goddess is a female god then also?
ということはあのあなたの神社の神様というのは女性なんでしょうか？
女性の場合もありますし、男性の場合もあります。なぜなら私はたくさんの神社で待っていますので、その神様の前で待っていますから、どちらとも言えません。
I can't really answer that question because I will perform the ritual dance at various different temples, and each temple has its own specific deity that might be male in form or female in form.
Okay, so be honored. I wish I have heard, of course, of Shinto and Shinto religion, but I really don't know enough. Can you give us an idea about the philosophy or the Shinto idea you...materialize in your movements, in your dance. What is Shinto, if it's easy to say in some words?
とても簡単に説明していただきたいんですけど、その神道というのはどういう宗教なの、あの、で、どう、それがどういうふうに、あの、舞の形に出て現れるのでしょうか。その神道という教えが、まあ、踊りの中を通してどうやって現れるのでしょうか。
この舞がということですよね。神道とが何かというわけではなく。
両方です。
ああ
のまあ、一般の人は神道のことあまり知らないので、とても簡単に説明するとしたらどういう。
神道というのは、日本人にとって一番、根本にある精神性だとか文化をあの物語っている宗教だと思います。宗教です。
I believe that Shinto is a religion that is really lies at the foundation of Japanese culture and Japanese philosophy.
それはもう宗教というよりは自然と日本人がどのように付き合ってきたのかということを表しているものだと私は思っています。
And rather than what you might think of when you think of religion, Shinto is really about the relationship between humankind and nature and how the two coexist.
舞はどういうことかと言いますと、先ほど私も言いましたが、神様に喜んでいただくために舞うものです。
And in terms of how Shinto relates to the ritual dance, as I explained earlier, we dance in order to please the deities.
To live in harmony this nature of mankind or to thrive to.
人類と、mm-hmm. 自然が仲良く生きていくという願いを込めてですか。
そうですね。
That's right.
Yeah. So you're also going to go, as Andrzej said, to Gießen to teach that dance. Are there many teachers that go around the world? Is there a diaspora of Kagura dancers, or is that a unique? Are you a unique a teacher in that sense?
Kagura を世界中に教えるっていう人がたくさんいるんですか。
私は知りませんね。いないでしょう。
I don't think there are many. I don't know of any others.
So you're the only one. So you will teach also male students then in Germany.
男性の生徒も持つことになりますよね。
そうですね。
Yes, that's right.
ただ私は神楽の巫女さんに皆さんになっていただきたいわけではありません。
But it's not as if I want everybody, all my students, to become the Miko, the priestess of Kagura, necessarily.
私は義仙大学応用演劇学科については一番重要なことは応用することだと思っています。応用、アンゲバンドテアカー義仙社。応用、カグラを応用することだとが一番重要だと思っています。
So I think that the really most important part of the teaching is for them to understand the Kagura and not become.
Is an idea. Mm-hmm. Well, tell us a little bit about the training. How do we become a Kagura dancer in the temple, for example? We have said four or five people are doing this in your town. When do you start, and how do you train, and how long, and where?
どうやってKagura を習うんですか。5人から10人。ミコさんがいたっておっしゃいましたが、そうどういう形でいつ何歳からトレーニングを始めて、
私がトレーニングを始めたのは8歳の時です。
I started training when I was 8 years old.
1年間神社で舞の型を学んで9歳からデビューしました。
So I learned the dance for 1 year, and then when I was 9 years old, I debuted as a performer.
The dance of war.
No, as a performer.
Oh, yeah.
で、どのようにして巫女になったのかということですが、私の地域では、その地域のだいたい8歳から9歳ぐらいの少女が10年に1回ぐらいのサイクルで選ばれていました。
10年から
10年に1回。それは20歳まででした、ね。
So in the region where I was, once every 10 years they would choose a new girl to join and start their training.
でちょうど私がその選ばれる時期に8歳だったということですね。
So right around the time where they were looking for a new dancer, I was about 8 years old.
Well, that is quite an honor, I'm sure, to be picked to communicate with the gods. Tell us about your shoes. Are these you took them off. I saw you took them off. Are they part of the dance or they are just for walking in? Or,
ですけど、
はい、
なんか靴についてちょっと話してくれますか。
靴についてですか。
あっていうか、なんかなぜ、
ね、脱ぐのか。ここが素敵なフロアだったからですね。
I took them off because the floor was so beautiful in this room.
で。もちろん外で舞うときは靴を履いて舞います。
Of course, when I dance outside, I keep my shoes on.
It would be in these shoes.
で、この靴で。
そうです。ですから室内も屋外も両方やっておりました。
Yeah, so I would perform indoors or outside as well. Mm-hmm.
So they are specially for performance or for dance?
この靴は舞うための靴ですか？特別な靴。
They're just regular
shoes.
Good. And about the fan, it has a silver side and a golden side. Is there a special meaning?
センスに金色側と銀色の側があるんですけど、それは意味があるんですか。
そうですね。これは舞扇です。金銀で黒い絵のものっていうのは、女性が持つことが多いと思いますが、魔除けの意味がありますね。
Yes, this is a specifically a fan for dancing. It's with the black frame and the silver on one side and the gold on the other. It is used mostly by women in dances to expel evil spirits.
So it's especially for dance. It's light and it's made out of wood then, or is this...
はい。
Yes, that's right.
これは8歳の時から持っています。Mm-hmm.
I've had this fan since I was 8 years old.
This one? Incredible. Before we come to audience question, a last question. Let's say today or this month or this year in the US or in the Americas, how often is Kagura performed? How rare was it what we saw now?
アメリカではカグラを見ることはもうあまりないですよね。どのぐらい今日見せていただいた前はどの程度貴重な経験体験だったんでしょうか、私たち
それは難しい。私がお答えるの難しいですね。大変貴重な時間、私にとっても皆さんにとっても大変貴重な時間だったと思います。そして、今日は4つの舞をコレクトしたんですけど、そんなに一度にたくさん見えることって普通はありませんから、良かったんじゃないでしょうか。
I think it's very rare for you to see Kagura, and it's hard for me to come out and say it, but for you and for myself, I think this is a very specialevent, and also it's very rare to see four pieces performed like this back to back. So in that sense, it was very rare.
Most probably no one has seen that, and I think in the U.S. So thank you for doing this. And I apologize that we have less time. We couldn't show all the four dances, but one day maybe at the Japan Society or somewhere else, we will see that. And my question to Andrzej, who I know you also are.Follow up the theater of Robert Wilson, who was a very contemporary man, but the slow movements, the dances, you know, the images, it seems like they are close characteristics of what we saw.
Well, of course, it's minimalism is very minimalistic, extremely minimalistic. But actually, I have also my question to Miho.In all her performances I attended and made possible in a certain way in Poland and in Germany and in Italy, she used the ritual music. And I wonder why we didn't hear the music now.
ポーランドとドイツとかで踊りをして時は音楽をかけたんです
ね。
今日はなぜ音楽を使わなかったんでしょうか。
それには理由があります。神楽とは何か、そのヨーロッパのツアーを終えてこのアメリカに来るまでに考えました。
There is a very good reason for that. Between my touring Europe andComing here to the States, I thought a lot about the meaning of Kagura.
もちろん、Kagura には音楽というのは大変重要なピースです。
Of course, music is a very important element in Kagura.
ただ、ここにいる皆さんとライブで感じるものが一番大事だと私は感じて、それが神楽の一番重要なポイントだと感じました。
However, I felt coming here that the most important thing that I wanted to communicate was this very special time that I had in front of the audience, this direct live performance element.
だからスピーカーから音楽が流れるのは違うなと
And I really thought that having the music piped in through the speakers would kind of take away from that experience.
もし私が音楽家を連れてくることができれば、それを今度はしましょう。
If I had been able to bring a live musician with me, well, that would have been another story. Maybe next time.
That is wonderful. Forrest, thank you so much. Maybe have some lights on the audience, and Tim will go around with a microphone. Not only so we hear you better, but this is also recorded, and it is live streamed. You can go back on our website and look at it again. I'm just going to call some numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4. So maybe we start over there. And hold it close, please.
I've been reading an 11th century Japanese novel, I'm sure you know it, the Genji of Murasaki.
Yeah,
Genji. So the theme of dance is quite prevalent. Men dance, it's upper class, I guess, portrait of upper class behavior. But for instance, the emperor, when he has a cabinet meeting, the cabinet members present their reports with dances. Well, there's also apotropaic dances that priests dance to dispel the evil spirits, which is a major theme in the novel. Mm-hmm. So that's 11th century, and then this Kagura is 13th century. So I wondered about how that Kagura relates to this practical presence of dance in the culture from before, where it grew out of something, and then where it went, where dance went afterward, and is there a presence in Japan today or recently? Yeah.
So in the book of Kenji, it is mentioned that many dances were done even in politics. So what is there a relation from Kagura to the Kenji time? And did it disappear, or was it always there every century after?
その時の11世紀の、源氏物語に出てきた踊りというものと、この Kagura の踊りというのは、何かつながりがあるのでしょうか。それとあとその13世紀から現在まではずっとカグラというものが存在してそのまま保ってきていたものでしょうか。
そうですね。カグラが一番古いものになりますね。
カグラ is known as the oldest form of dance。
それは、古事記というのがあれは8世紀。
It appears in an ancient literature called the Kojiki, and that was written in the 8th century.
その時に、雨のうずめの御事という女性が舞ったのが神楽芸能の始まりでもあると言われています。
And in that work, there's a woman named 雨の
うずめの御事。
うずめの御事 who dances, and that is kind of the first recorded dance.
And his second question, so all of the centuries Kagura was performed?
それで、その時から現在までずっとそのままの形で続いてきたんですか？
そうですね。そうとも言えますし、そうでもないと言えます。昔はビデオがありませんでしたから、すべて口伝でしたね。で、今日お見せした映像は神社に、残っているので、あれが1700年頃に描かれた絵です。はい。
So, yes and no. Because in the olden days, in the ancient times, of course, there were no video cameras. So, you know, all the dances were passed down from generation to generation orally. In the slideshow that you saw, in the video that you saw today, we saw paintings of the dances, and those are they're actually preserved in the temple.
いつ頃からなんですか？それは今、300年ほど前。
And those are about 300 years old.
それを、当時のものを残すために描かれた絵です。
And they were drawn in order to preserve the form. And to hand down to the next generation.
That's connotation. What was number two? Yeah, okay. Oh, okay.
Hi, thank you very much. Arigato.
Arigato gozaimasu.
I was noticing when you were dancing associations with at least three other dancers. One is the contemporary Japanese couple Aiko and Kona. who dance really slowly, and they are modern dancers for theater audiences. Also, it reminded me of Japanese tea ceremony, where direction and concentration is a meditation. And the third, which particularly surprised me, was not Japanese, the part of the dance where you turned, you had the bells in one hand and the fan in the other, and exactly the way you turned, one foot over the other, swirling, was very much like the dervishes, the whirling dervishes, who dance as worship. So because of these different associations, my question is, when you perform these dances, what is your emotional or mental state? Is it a state of worship?
Yeah, let's try to translate.
が質問なんですけど、その前にいろいろ見ている最中にいろんなこととのつながりを見て、A 子とコマの舞踏が2年見ているところもあったし、お茶をする時に見てたし、あと最後はトルコの解決にも見てたので、でも質問はどういうことを考えながら、
そうですね、なんてこういうふうにお答えしたら一番いいのか今考えてるんですが、何も考えず何も持たないということです。だから私は待っている時に、小さな空間が自分の中にあるというような感覚を持っています。
When I'm dancing, I try to not think of anything, not hold onto anything. I imagine that I hold an empty space inside me.
これは、8歳の時にはもちろん分かりませんでした。10年ぐらい経って卒業する頃ぐらいにようやく、私にとってそれが一番重要なことだというふうに感じました。
Of course, that is not something that I understood when I was 8 years old. But when I was about 18, after 10 years of dancing, I came to understand that having that emptiness inside me was probably the most important thing for me in my dance.
Yeah, two more questions. One was here.
Not a question, a compliment.
One second. Yeah, okay, we'll take the microphone.
Not a question, a compliment. I think I speak for everyone here. Express our admiration at the beauty, the grace, the charm that you exhibited this evening. It did not require a musical accompaniment, which traditionally we are so accustomed to in the United States. You were just incredible, absolutely.
本当に素晴らしかった。質問ではなくて、音楽も必要なく。
Thank you.
Thank you. The question relates to teaching of the dance. You said that you took you about 1 year to study the movements and the steps.
Of one dance, right?
ダンスを舞いを習うことについて質問したいんですけど、1年、8歳の時から1年習っていたっていうのは、一つの演目を習っていたんですか？
ですね、6つですね。そしてそれに、バリエーションがあります。1人前から4人前まで。
Actually, that first year she was studying six, different pieces, and some of them were solos and some of them were, dances performed with, by four performers at the same time.
だから24になりますね。そうなると。6×24 なので。
Oh, 演目が6つ。
演目が6つあって、1つずつに1人前から4人前まで。
だから全部覚えないとダメ。
そうですね。はい。
So she would have to、learn all the parts.、there are six pieces that could be performed for, by up to four people, which meant she had to learn 24 parts.
There were six dancers, and each dance had up to four performers, so she learned 24 parts. But you had a second part of your question.
Second part is that well, I'm coming from the classical ballet, and thousands of steps and figures. What was the most difficult part in your year of study of this dance which you perform?
その最初の1年のトレーニングの中で一番大変だった、難しかったことは何だったんでしょう？
一番難しかったことですか？鈴をいつも一定の位置に保つことでしょうか？
Probably the most difficult thing was to be able to hold the bells in one position.
So they don't make a sound.
あとは、特に私は難しいとは感じていませんでした。
But to tell you the truth, I never felt that it was difficult for me.
And、to conclude the evening, will you show us, is it possible to do a closing piece of a dance?
何か一番最後にもう一つだけ舞うことは可能でしょうか？
あ、もちろんです。
Yes,
yeah?
Of course.
Oh, oh, wonderful. Again, thank you.
Dobre.
Where are the bells? Where did the bells go? Oh, I'm putting it on.
coming and for staying in the little reception honor for dance coming over here in the room. Thank you.